Good morning, everyone. Today I already recorded one video, and that was an important thing I needed to finish today. I then plan to do a couple of things for the rest of the day. I'm going to hire an editor on Reedsy for a new book that is coming out. It will be a huge, big book, lots of work. I worked with this editor before, so I feel comfortable that she can handle that book. So we're going to start working on it in August. The next thing I need to do is I need to review the progress for the website development. That will be a huge one because we are going to be launching the new site very soon, later this year. So I have to make sure that there are no big mistakes that we cannot fix later. Like if there will be issues with redirects for our articles, things like that. I have to be very careful to make sure we don't have any issues. The other thing I need to do is I need to create a new title for one of the new novels that will be coming out, a different book from the one I mentioned earlier today. And I need to create a title in Ingramspark, and I'm going to record everything and show you guys how to do it. And then I need to create a cover template that I need to send to my designer so she can prepare the template, so she can prepare the cover, and so that I can then upload it to Ingramspark. And then I have about 10 episodes I need to review today for the core program. That will be a program with Kevin Coyne, Advanced Competitive Strategy. I need to review 10 episodes and send feedback to editor. And I need to prepare another article on FIRMSconsulting.com because readers find it very helpful to have articles, and also it's very important for search engines. Basically, this is how we get traffic. People find us on Google, they search for something, they find our article, they come to our site, they like our training, they sign up for our email list, and we get to know them, they get to know us, and if they like our training, they sign up for our training. And then if I still have time, I want to try to find a missing module. Believe it or not, a missing module in one of the programs. I went through all the footage and I cannot find one module. Module 9 is missing for advanced competitive strategy. So I need to figure out where is that module, where is it hiding? It must be somewhere, we recorded it, so I have to find it. Maybe it was misfiled somewhere. So this is my exciting day. And we already finished big part of the day. I'm starting this vlog late. Anyway, so let me continue with my work and I'm going to check with you later. Oh, by the way, can you see the stairs? How they're incomplete? So the entire house looks kind of complete. You see, very polished, beautiful. And the stairs, a complete disaster. And that is because what happened is initially the contractor put pink bullnose. I said that I'm not going to accept it because I didn't order the pink bullnose. I ordered the same color as the floor. So we tried to figure out what to do. And then one of the employees painted the bullnose. By the way, I wanted to share with you what the new succeeding as a management consultant looks like. Let me show you this beauty. This is a matte cover. When I'm going to show you guys how to work with Ingramspark, this is what matte cover looks like. I do see this issue of misalignment of the text. It seems like misalignment, but it really is not, because the cover starts here. So, but it does look a little weird, even though the cover actually starts here. So it kind of correct. But I need to see if I can fix it. But anyway, I wanted to show you because I'm going to be showing you guys how to use Ingramspark. And this is 6x9 size. This is another of our books. This is Turquoise Eyes. This is a novel and this is more educational. They're both educational, but this is more of a novel and this is more of a textbook. Although this one is probably the most interesting textbook to read in the world, to me at least, because it's written as a novel, but with a heavy educational aspect. So this is 6x9, both of them are 6x9. As you can see, it is a very lovely size, right? It's very comfortable for your hand to hold. I have an average height, so my hand is average size. That's what average person will have in terms of size of their hand. So it's super comfortable to use, to hold. So if you want a book like this, in Ingramspark, you need to select 6x9, and then you need to select a matte cover. A gloss cover will be shiny. This is, you see, it's not shiny, matte. And you need to select a hard cover. And this is actually not an expensive paper, because expensive paper would increase the cost for our clients, and we try to keep costs as low as possible. So this is what it looks like. If you print 6x9 matte cover, and you can print in colors, you can see some of those are in color here. Okay, so I'm just going to write down the things I need to finish today. So one is the video, which I already finished. Second is I need to hire an editor on Reedsy for the new book. I need to add a title on Ingramspark. I also need to create a template for the cover on Ingramspark and send it to designer. Then I need to write an article on FIRMSconsulting. I need to edit a video and export for YouTube. I need to review work in progress for the new site. And if I have super productive day, highly unlikely, I also want to review 10 episodes from Advanced Competitive Strategy course. And it looks like I need to buy some new markers. And if I am super, super, super productive, I also would like to find a missing episode from Advanced Competitive Strategy. So this is my plan for today. Editor on Reedsy, and what is great about Reedsy is they check the editors, so the quality of editors you're going to find on the platform are quite good. So here's what you need to do. You need to go to my books and you need to create a new book. Let's say strategy 2. You press create. And then you go looking for editor. Strategy 2, then you go manage, hire professional. So we have book strategy 2, looking for a professional editor to do editing. The platform will suggest some editors for you, so you will need to select the ones you want to go ahead with. So I would take a look at reviews. Generally, that's a good indication, and response rate and location. So usually people who are located in London or New York will have higher rates than people who are located in cheaper places in the world. So let's say we select the following people. We select this lady, we select this lady, this person. We're going for higher reviews, so we're going for a higher amount of 5-star reviews, so maybe 10 plus. Reedsy only lets you select 5 people, so we selected the first 5 people that came up with high number of reviews. And you see what happened is, because I already sent a request this week for another book that I'm editing, the platform actually doesn't let me reach out to more people. But the way you avoid it is try to be very selective when you reach out during the week to 5 editors. Do your research, then select those editors, reach out to them. And as a backup, you can also reach out to people on Upwork, and there you don't have limit on how many jobs you can post in a week. But I would not recommend publishing multiple job posts without hiring people, because that will impact your standing as a job provider, because clients on Upwork also have statistics that people are looking for, so how many people you actually hired. So for example, I think people can see percentage of jobs you actually hired for. So I always publish a new job when I'm certain that I'm gonna hire somebody for this job on Upwork. Otherwise, your numbers will go down. Work in progress from web developers and designer, and let me just show you how beautiful the new design looks. So for comparison, let me show you the old site first. As you can see, it loads very slowly. Huge issue we have, and this is the design we have. Our membership options, and for example, if we go to a blog post, as you can see, even the logo looks very grainy, doesn't look clear, and overall it looks kind of cheap. Okay, so let me show you the new design. As you can see, it's much more beautiful. So this is the home page, the new home. You can select where you want to go. You can opt in for our email list here. You can see our beautiful programs. Then you can read about various books we have. You can read about our step-by-step studies, our testimonials, look at different options we have in terms of memberships, Q&As, watch videos with people giving feedback about using our programs. And this will be the new podcast page with Spotify playlists, where you can go to different playlists based on your interests and listen to specific podcasts within that playlist. You can read about what people say about the podcast. For websites, it's crucial to have mobile optimized website. This is mobile homepage. So this is what the mobile homepage will look like when you look at it on your phone. I think it looks very sleek, beautiful, unique, and very much in line with what I want our company to look like. So this is one of my favorite places to rest if I have a few minutes. This is my scarf that shouldn't be here, but I'm being naughty. I really love this place. Then we have a little table here and two books. So I know many of you guys will be starting your businesses, and I just wanted to say that just remember that it's really hard in the beginning. So don't be discouraged if things don't go your way. We started FIRMSconsulting 10 years ago. 10 years ago, and it's still a slog every single day. It's much easier than it was before. It's much easier. But it's still incredibly long hours. You still working at 11 o'clock at night. You're working at 5 o'clock in the morning when you have to. You're working as soon as you wake up, you start your work, you finish late at night. So you never take proper vacations, you never take weekends off. You probably could if you wanted to, but you're constantly competing with other companies who are trying to copy you, trying to steal your clients. And we have a lot of issues like that. We have people copying us, and then we have to deal with that. They literally copy everything. They copy our slides, they copy our unique frameworks and approaches. So what I'm trying to say is, don't be discouraged. It's not easy to run a business. It's not. I wish it was, but it's not easy. But at the same time, you know, if it was easy, everyone would do it, right? If it was easy, everyone would be successful. Life is, it's hard. It's hard to be an entrepreneur, but it is rewarding. As long as you pick something where you feel that you are doing something important for the world, this is what will keep you going. If it's just money, it's not going to keep you going. It's not going to be enough. You're going to get tired and frustrated, and you will want to give up. You will wonder why life that your friends have, that have full-time jobs, some company, why their life is so much easier, why they can go on vacation, why they can switch off at night, why they can rest over the weekend. So if you pick something just to make money, you're going to get disappointed. You're going to give up most likely because it's so hard. There's so much competition and you're going to deal with a lot of not nice people who will pretend to be nice in the beginning. Many people don't say anything about it because they're trying to be very positive, but it is the reality. You're going to end up working with a lot of people who will take your money and they will promise you things and they will not deliver what they promised. Or they will deliver, but you have to lose 2-3 years of your life in terms of your health dealing with them and begging them and explaining to them that you're not supposed to take people's money and then not deliver. It happened to us so many times when we end up working with people like that. Even this year, it happened to us more than once. And now, knowing what we know, we are navigating the situations like that. We are planning in advance and protecting the company from people like that. But what you will discover as an entrepreneur is that most people promise a lot and they don't deliver. They just want to get paid. They will say anything to get paid and then they hope that you're not gonna demand, that you will be lazy, that you will just accept whatever they give you, that you will accept it. So be ready that it will be hard, but it's also going to be exciting. It will be exciting to create something for the world that never existed before. And it exists now because you created it and it impacts other people's lives, and other people's lives are better because you were here, because you were not lazy, because instead of watching Lost or Game of Thrones, you were working in front of your computer, creating something wonderful for the world that now impacts people in all walks of life and in all parts of the world. So don't be discouraged. Be ready that it will be hard. Plan for it and focus on key work. One of the key things I realized for myself is that before 3 p.m. every day, I need to focus on key work. And there's so much power in it. Because in the morning, you have the most energy, you think much more clearer, and you need to use that time to focus on the most important work. And you will start noticing progress if you do that. Don't do busy work. Don't do work that doesn't impact anything. That kind of needs to be done, but if you don't do it, it will not make such a big difference. Like posting on social media. Yes, it's important to have a social media profile. If you don't, people would think why you don't have a social media platform. Is there something wrong? But at the same time, how much value it's gonna bring you? It will eventually when you have a huge profile, but to get there, it's not even necessarily possible at this point in time. On some platforms, you're not gonna grow organically, with some exceptions. Like for example, on Instagram now, you're not gonna grow organically just on Instagram. If you have a YouTube channel, people will come there from YouTube and your Instagram will grow. If you advertise, your Instagram will grow, but your organic reach will be terrible. So things like that. So focus on what is the key work that you came here to do, you were born to do, and focus on that. And do the least important work late in the day when you're tired and you can't really pay much attention. This is what Ingramspark looks like. So I created a new title. It's not completed yet. I still have to add actual manuscript and I have to add cover. And I actually recorded how I created this for you guys. So you will be able to see this as a separate video that takes you through the steps in case you need to create a title for your book on Ingramspark. But it's actually very easy. And now if you later want to order a book, all you do is you just select the book you want to order. You see, now it doesn't let you order, but generally you would be able to, but now it doesn't because of what's going on with the pandemic. But generally this is what you would do. You will select the book, and this is what the article post looks like on our backend. This is a WordPress backend, and this is the article that I'm working on publishing. This is where you load your image. You can load additional images inside the article here, and you have to just make sure that you selected a good keyword. I use keyword planner to select the keyword. And I can make a separate video explaining exactly what I do to optimize articles for search engines. But in short, I select the keyword via keyword planner, Google Keyword Planner, and then I make sure that I use it in the title, and the title has to be heading 1, H1. Then I use it in the first paragraph. As you can see, I'm using it right here in the very beginning. This is our keyword, and I use it in some subtitles, which is H2. This is important for search engines. So basically it is heading 2, H2. I use it in some of it, and I use it at the very end like that. I use it again here. Ideally, for search engine optimization, we probably should not have this part, and I may delete it in the future. I'm including it now because many people don't know that we have books, and our current site is not really designed well to explain that we have books, and I think books are such a great way to learn about our training at a very low cost, because books are generally cheap. So I want people to know that they have an option to buy a book from us and learn about our training, get to know us better before committing to becoming members. So this is basically ready, and I just published it, but I will show you how I do it. I just select public. It was private before. I select public. I say okay. And some other things you need to know for search engine optimization, and I use plugin to help me. You can see here. I make sure that I select tags starting with the actual keyword, best business podcasts. And then I just take a look and see what else is wrong. So right now they're saying that I should use it in more subheadings. And you can see I'm not using it in many. I only have it in 3 subheadings out of many subheadings. But it just doesn't make sense to use it in other parts. So I'm gonna keep it as is. Because at the end of the day, it needs to primarily be good for a reader. And only as a second priority, be good for spiders. Again, they're saying that it's not at the beginning. This I probably could fix. Do we really need to say it's 8? Maybe we just say best business podcasts in 2020. And this problem is fixed. As you can see, everything is slow. That's another thing you have to do as an entrepreneur. You have to be patient. Things don't work well. This is an old computer, but we're gonna roll with it. And everything else is good. You can see we have outbound links, which basically links to other sites, not to firmsconsulting.com, but to other sites. We have internal links, which is links within our site. Key phrase and introduction, which is basically the first paragraph. Length is good. Key phrase density, 13 times. Could be better if I had more, but 13 is fine. Key phrase and meta description. This is our meta description. So fine, it's included. You've never used this key phrase before, and I specifically, by the way, select key phrase that I haven't used before. Image had a key phrase on purpose, of course. The length is good, 2500 words is good. Usually you need at least 500 words, so I'm well above that. Key phrase is in title and in slug. What is slug? It is this little thing. So basically something that you can select for each particular article. You can edit it here and you include your keywords. And generally it is considered that the shorter the slug, well, the shorter your overall URL, the better. The issue we have with our URL is that we have quarterly/quarterly/ best business podcasts, and our website name is a little long, so that doesn't help us with search engine optimization. But because of how it is structured, how the website structured, I have to kind of work with it now. And this is what happens when you don't know anything in the beginning. As an entrepreneur, you don't know anything. So you work with developers and they set up terrible website structure and you have no idea that it is the case. In our case, our developers actually wiped out our entire search traffic. They basically did not redirect. When we redesigned our site a long time ago, 2013 or 2012, something like that, they did not redirect. Basically from old links to new links, and we lost all our traffic. All the articles that were showing up in search engine will send people to our website. They will come to our website and they will see error message, they will see error page, because they were not redirects. Redirect happens when, for example, you go to a page and then you automatically get redirected to a correct page. So this is the type of thing you have to deal with as an entrepreneur. It's okay, it comes with the territory. I'm now reviewing episodes from Advanced Competitive Strategy. No, actually, I'm reviewing episodes today from Competitive Strategy, a course before Advanced Competitive Strategy. So, let's start. We have a lot of episodes to review. I'm starving and I'm going to make myself some tea. This is my favorite bath. Very nice. It looks like this. If you guys haven't tried it, it's so delicious. And this one is another one to try. This one is with chocolate. It's so nice. And I generally allergic to chocolate, so I cannot even have it a lot. But my body can handle one a day, most days. But I do take breaks to make sure I don't get really allergic. But this one is lifesaver when you're hungry. This is another life hack I wanted to show you. So if you want to have white teeth, and if you struggle with whitening strips, well, I use whitening strips approximately every week, but they hurt and I cannot use them more than that because they really hurt my teeth. This is a big lifesaver because it basically keeps your teeth whiter, so you need to whiten it less and you suffer less. And obviously it's not good for you to whiten your teeth because of all the stuff that they use in the whitening strips, so this is a good thing. You can get them on Amazon. You can also get paper straws, so there are options, and it makes a big difference. And I also use them for smoothies, again to protect your teeth. And if you're not tolerating milk well, and many people do not tolerate milk well, this is a great substitute. This is a goat milk, low fat. I'm very sensitive to milk. My body doesn't like any milk products. So this is a big lifesaver for me as well. And I think even for people who tolerate milk, their body tolerates goat milk better. And I'm sure there are other many options like oat milk and so on, but this is just option that I prefer for myself. Just wanted to share with you guys. Hi guys, I'm back home from my daily walk and I'm going to make a smoothie, something I'm trying to do every single night because it's very healthy. And I usually work with whatever I have. So today all I have is this banana and some parsley. But I think it will be delicious. So it is 8:43 p.m. Let's see what we have done today. So we recorded video, we sent an invite to hire an editor on Reedsy. We added title to Ingramspark, and I recorded that video for you separately so you guys can learn how to do it if you need this information. Then I created template cover for Ingramspark. Again, recorded it for you guys so you can use it if you need it, and send template to designer. I wrote an article. This I'm going to do tonight. I started working on it, but I haven't completed yet. I reviewed work in progress. I reviewed a little bit, not everything, and I haven't found the missing episode. So that is something I can work on tomorrow. So I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Let me know in the comments what kind of footage you guys want me to show you in the future vlogs, what you find interesting, what you find boring, what you would like to see more of, less of. Please let me know in the comments, would love to hear from you. And subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to the channel. I'm planning to publish 3 videos per week on Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday at 7 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And I'm trying to accomplish a goal of 10,000 subscribers by the end of December. So if you subscribe, you will really be helping me out. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm looking forward to see you next time.